Hello everyone, welcome. So let's continue what we have started in the previous part. So now we will add the materials, and materials has been set up in the previous part. So let's continue. After this loading, we will add three image textures. The first one will be the color, the second one will be the roughness, and the third one will be the normal map. So we have this image, which is color, and secondly we have this one. We will try to add this. It has been done in I have made in Adobe Photoshop, and let's start by making this normal map. So let's see how it looks here, and I think we have now added the materials. We can see that the strength is high. Let's say it will be 0.6. So after that, we can say we have an color, and let's say brightness. It will be brighter 3 times. Maybe it's high. So contrast will be like this. Let's try another one, which is a hue saturation, and so we will adjust these values to be a yellow shape. So as you can see, it's now a process of trial and error. And I think if we added before this a brightness or maybe RGB curves, let's see. And if we increase the specular like this, I think now it may be similar to our shape. And now we will try to add something, which is the UV unwrapping, and we will unwrap this in a way that can be folded. So let's first I will select this edge, and or maybe selecting this edge and mark seam. Let's try another time UV unwrap. We first match apply rotation and scale, and unwrapping it might be not correct. So as you can see, it like this. So we can select this one. Let's see. Let's mark seam and select this one. Clear this seam, and let's try to define this to be a seam, and try another time unwrapping. And as you can see, it's folded correctly. So I must say that we have unlimited or a lot of ways to unwrapping or even unwrapping this shape, but we will process for this one. We can increase this scale to be 5 and 5 and 5. and this will be a wrapper, and a wrapper will be principled BSDF, and then it will be a black like this. Specular maybe 0.2 and the roughness maybe 0.4. And this one, let's see how it looks. So it has two parts. This part which is here, let's zoom, will be add a rubber part. And to control I, and this will be this material which will be red plastic, and let's select the again principled, and another time will be like this. Let's say the specular will be 0.15 and the roughness will be 0.3. In the viewport shading we can see it will be like this, and another time so we have made the shape, and we now we are going to make this diamond or maybe metal shape. So in a new layer we will start from shift C, and we will add a cone, and this cone let's see how it looks. It isn't, it has a lot of vertex, so let's delete and add another cone, and let's see how it looks. So it has 32 vertices, let's say it will be 16 vertices, and maybe 20, and dimensions let's say it will be 0.1 and 0.2, and then we have the chance to define a material. It will be a gold material. Now let's add the principle BSDF, then it will be a gold like this one. Specular will be around point, let's say 0.2, but it will be a metallic, and this one will be a brighter color. Then we may add some anisotropic, and this roughness will be like this. 0.3 is too high, let's say 0.2, and specular 0.3. Alright, let's add the smooth shading, and so I will make all these values are zero, then G and Z like this. Another time we will make another cone. As you can see in this picture, we have lot of cones. We have around four types of cones. I will add another cone, and this cone will be, let's increase this time, will be 15, maybe 15, 45, and this cone will be a smooth shading, and let's add a gold material. Then I will scale in shift Z 0.5 and scale in Z 0.4 and move like this. Shift D duplicate another time and duplicate another time. This will be scaled like this. Scale shift Z 0.6 and this will be not gold. We have two gold and two which will be not gold but another metal material. So it will be these two will be gold and this let's try another metallic and it will be let's disable all these values and let's say it will be have more roughness and let's say it will be less specular. This also will be share the same material and I think we will scale in the axis like this. So the next step is to make all this to be a group and we will name this group to be a gems. And now we have the chance to select this one and make an particle which will be surface. This will be another surface. So the number this will be here and advanced from volume. Let's go here in the render will be a group to be a gems. As you can see now the scale is very big, so we will go here to all these one and scale them 0.2. Apply rotation and scale. Let's go here. As you can see now we have this shape. So after selecting all these